Ladies and gentlemen, and my Nana, welcome to day two of the Call of Duty stream here at ACL Melbourne 2015. I'm Emaniac. I have the pleasure of being joined today to kick off the stream with Benny Sim. First up, we've got a winner's bracket round three match of True Ambition Naga versus the guys over at Citadel. Now, Benny Sim, this is going to be a pretty intense match. Top three they're playing for now.
Yeah, certainly. Obviously progressing pretty quickly through this bracket here, the winner's bracket, I should mention. And two top teams going up against each other. Obviously Citadel, one of the favourites coming into this match. A lot of people have speculated them to actually take it out. And True Ambition, want to try and stop them in that path there. Obviously they've got a pretty strong lineup themselves. And we're going to quickly go into that lineup there. There is Snopey on this team here, Pastels. They've also got Trent, as you see on the screen there, and the fourth player is Metz. So some real young players coming through there, and I just want to highlight Trent. Played extremely well yesterday, and I expect him to back that up again today.
Yeah, if you didn't mention him, I was definitely going to. Trent was very impressive up on the main stage yesterday. You guys would have seen on the stream. If you didn't get a chance to check out the action yesterday, make sure you check out the VODs when they are released by searching ACL Pro Video on YouTube. So that's your True Ambition Naga lineup. Up against them are going to be the guys from Citadel. Now, Citadel, their last match was a 3-0 over Peppa Pig. Now, the name might be funny, but their Call of Duty skills are not. They were a very strong squad, and Citadel mopped the floor with them. With that said, Naga's last match was also a 3-0 over the guys at Textbook Gaming. So, both of these teams coming hot out of here with 3-0s. Citadel here made up of Stu, Jims, Dismal, and Carrie. Got to watch out for these guys, Benny.
Yeah, exactly right. Unfortunately, Jims isn't able to play. They're going to use a replacement who will be Lakey, who will be actually going to Worlds with this squad here. So pretty strong team, as you see. They've got Stu there, who recently or previously has attended over at COD Champs last year, or this year, I should say. So definitely look out for those. And we're going to start off with the Detroit Hardpoint. So very close, hard-paced game to start off with, and it's going to be interesting to see which way it goes on this one.
Yeah, that's right, Benny. For those of you playing at home and don't know how we roll here, the format of ACL Melbourne is a best-of-five series, so we're going to have three maps at minimum, kicking things off, of course, as always, with the Hardpoint, this time on Detroit, a favourite map here of myself and a couple of teams here at the event. Benny, just while we're getting this one revved up, quite a surprising amount of talent we've had here. You know, a smaller event in team numbers compared to the usual, but, I mean, there's been some real highlights here.
Yeah, certainly. Obviously, we've been able to see a few teams on the main stage that we generally wouldn't see, such as Peppa Pig, as you did mention earlier. And they've definitely turned a few heads around at this tournament, and they well deserve their place in. They're still, obviously, in the tournament, as we do speak, in the lower bracket there, but they're still going to continue their run. So we're going to jump straight into this game. We're going to start off with Carrie, see what he can do off that break. Obviously, he's got the ASM1 in his hand, and it looks like he's just going to be pushing through this hospital section here. He's going to get contested from one player. Unfortunately, does get taken down. That it is Trent picking up the first kill on him. And the team of Citadel will have a little bit of early control here as Trent's trying to push through the back.
Yeah, Trent here from True Ambition Naga is going to be picking up the first blood here of the stream today, and he's going to be following up with the second killers there. Another player coming through the window. He's going to get it. Tries to react. Not going to be good enough. Carry picking that one up. Stu and Dismal, though, taking a fall. And look at this. Your kill feed lighting up red as the guys here from True Ambition are starting to get control of this first Atlas hardpoint. You can see the spawn is going to be pushing in. The pre-fire out from Pass isn't going to hit anyone, but the one coming out the rear is definitely going to get picked that one up. And look at your kill feed, Benny. All red, True Ambition starting off the day hot.
Yeah, certainly. They've just hit the lead there. Obviously, the team of Citadel had a nice little start. They were uncontested, but Pastel's here. He's only had two contestions in that hard point. He's been able to rack up the point, and he has to pick up another kill there. He's currently on a 3-kill streak, and the final few seconds should go in favour of True Ambition here. Unfortunately, Pastel does go down, but look at the rotation. Metz is in the hard point early on, and the team of Citadel, they're trying to push that flank there, trying to get those spawns as Met wisely backs off. Unfortunately, does get taken down there by Dims, and it looks like the team of Citadel have been able to break this.
Considering how strong True Ambition were holding down that Atlas hardpoint, they had at least two, maybe three of their players over there. I'm surprised Citadel didn't get their rotation easy as pie over here at this second green hardpoint, but no, it was actually the player from True Ambition who was there early, and as you can see here, this is very much True Ambition's hardpoint. There's a great spawn out the back of green here, though, for the guys from Citadel. Stu's going to lead the charge, but the player in the corner, Pass, is going to pick it up, and he's still holding it down. He's on a four, made that 5-kill streak, nice 3-pick. piece there, taking down Carrie and Lakey as well. This is all past right now. He's going to be tagged up a little bit, backing out. Gets the player coming through green. That's six massive kills in a row. This is Pastel's hardpoint.
Yes, certainly. As you said, Pastel's was in the original hardpoint. We're able to hold down the second hardpoint there. And look at that rotation. We'll just highlight the mini map, and it has all been true ambition. They've currently got three players, and the bottom left-hand side is all going red. So they've got to yet again another setup. They're able to get some valuable points as Kerry unfortunately doesn't pick up the kill there, as Metz was able to take him down. As Lakey's trying to get these spawns, he's able to pick up the kill there, and they should be able to hold these spawns. There is Pastels yet again in the hard point. Let's see where they can get a couple of kills.
Yeah, and indeed he can. He's got three in a row, makes that four. Pastels is going off this morning here at the main stage at ACL Melbourne. There's going to be a player coming up the back stairs. He's going to have backup of his teammate. He needs to watch himself. That pre-fly almost hit the teammate. Carrie's going to pick up one on the outside. Dismal also following up. Carrie follows it up with a two-piece. Nice work there by Carrie. Three kills in a row to clear out this hard point. And that's exactly what they need to do. 18 seconds left on the hard point. They need to rack it up. 88 to 46 is your score. We're going to be setting up very soon for the next rotation. But I tell you what, Benny Sim, these guys from True Ambition looking strong this morning.
Yes, certainly. As you said, Pastels and Trent have started off extremely well for their team at True Ambition. And look at the rotation yet again. It's all True Ambition. They gave it the last 10 seconds, but they did rotate early. As Metz able to pick up one, unfortunately isn't able to pick up the second kill there, as we're going to have a few contests at the back, and it looks like True Ambition were able to win that, and they controlled those spawns coming through the back, so they should be able to flood this quite easily, as we do see Dismal pick up a nice little two-piece there. Unfortunately, one player does get caught, and that's Snopey pick up a two-piece himself, looking for the third, but unfortunately does get taken down, and it looks like Kerry's going to be sitting in the hard point as he does get taken down by Pastels.
Yeah, that's right. There was actually a very nice spawn there for the guys at Citadel down out the back there, but unfortunately they were all taken out. Ducks in a row for the guys at True Ambition. Pastels, he's got so much pre-fire, didn't end up hitting anyone. The team nade there from Snopey is going to take down Pastels, who was on fire. Stu taking down Snopey, so you've got Kerry and Lakey here from the guys at Citadel holding this one down, and we saw there was about a 40 to 45 second gap between these two teams. It's now been cut down to about 20 seconds, but as I say, that True Ambition are back in control as we set up for the last rotation over here to the school, and as you can see, this time around, it's going to be in the hands of Citadel.
Yeah, certainly. Citadel are starting to fire up a little bit here, but unfortunately, Metz does pick up a two-piece, says no thank you, as we do see the nades flying in through that hard point, as it generally does, as we are on board with Lakey, just pre-firing that door, see whether he's able to pick up a couple of kills here, but unfortunately doesn't, and his teammate's able to pick up one. Stu trying to get turned on the second, unfortunately gets taken down, and that was three down for the team at Citadel, and it looks like the control's going to go back in favour of True Ambition.
Yeah, everyone we jumped to from Citadel there was taken out, unfortunately for them. We're back on board here with Snopey from True Ambition as he gets dropped. Pastels does as well. Citadel fighting back with a vengeance. There's now about 12 to 15 seconds separating these teams. So Citadel are coming back. You know, they were starting to win a few gunfights. Stu got six in a row. We did see the guys from True Ambition being nothing but hot at the beginning, but for the first time as we hit the halfway mark, it looks like Citadel are going to get in control. And Benny, after the first four rotations, I did not see this coming.
Yes, certainly. As you did say, True Ambition had an early control there, but unfortunately, Citadel have been able to bring this back due to a lot of kills they're getting here, as we do see Kerry pick up another kill through Pit here. The rotation did happen from Lakey, but unfortunately does get taken down by Metz, and it looks like Pastel is going to jump in this hard point. It was his hard point to start off with. Unfortunately, Stu does take him down, and Lakey's able to exchange those kills as Snopey does get taken down. Lakey, nice little two-piece in the background there. None of the players from Citadel are really going positive at this current stage, but they're all doing their part of this, all they require, and Kerry gets a nice little turn on, looks for the second kill, unfortunately does get taken down, but look at that score, it's within 10 points, going into the second rotations here, as Snopey picks up one, Pastel's able to pick up another kill, Snopey looks for the third, unfortunately he's had to reload his clip there and does get taken down as we see a team kill coming from Trent.
This is such a close game, what a way to start off the day here in the ACL Melbourne main stage. You just pointed out KDs a little before, I just want to point out how even this scoreboard is right now. From the highest to lowest kills on the Citadel squad, it's 19 to 15, so only four kills separating them. Over on the other side of True Ambition, you've got 18 to 21, so three kills separating them. This is such an even scoreboard, Benny, and it's just about who's capitalizing on the points, and with 139 apiece for both teams there just for a second, it looks like both of them are. These teams are so evenly matched here on this map and game type.
Yes, certainly, but you see the spawns in favour of the team of Citadel here, as Trent's in the hard point, trying to get a couple of kills, and he's going to get contested. Unfortunately, does get taken down, and that's a couple of players down, but Pastel says no yet again. This was his hard point to start off, and he's picked up a nice little two-piece, trying to pre-aim that door there, as he is aware where the players from Citadel are spawning, And it looks like they're going to stretch that lead out to just over 10 points. And Pastels, 23 and 20. As you said, no one's really standing out, but he's getting a lot of important kills as he unfortunately does get taken down. A little bit sloppy kills, shots from coming from him. But Carey was able to do that drop shot, pick him up, and pull back this score. Yet again, we're within 1 point.
Yeah, we saw the drop shot coming out from Carey's drop was just a little bit better. You've now got Trent and Metz picking up the scrap points as we're going to be rotating over to the car park. And yet again, this time it's going to be Citadel. They're finally getting their rotations down packed, and it seems to be working for him, Benny.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, we do need to see Stu pick up a couple of kills, but unfortunately does get taken down as Snopey's able to push that, but unfortunately does get shut down by Lakey there. And it looks like the team of Citadel do control these spawns, and Carey was able to pick up a kill, and hopefully they can get back into this game here. Obviously, it's only a six-point game, but this is a valuable hard point. Obviously, with only 2.5 minutes left, they need to get some valuable time on this one if they want to keep themselves in this game or push that victory. As Lakey picks up one, gets a second, goes for the third piece. Big plays coming out of Lakey, and that stops the push coming from the team of True Ambition. Look where they spawned. They all spawned in that school section, and it takes them around 5 to 10 seconds to be pushing back into this hard point.
Yeah, let's see how they're going to break in. We've got Pass leading the charge. He's going to pick up one, but he's going to be dropped down. Lakey picks up two before being dropped himself. Carey answers back with the swift revenge. Snopey trying to get to save some face here for the True Ambition squad, but it's going to be all Citadel. They were here in control from the start, and now they've done the wise thing. They've gone for the early rotation over to Yellow just to try and get some of these points back. There's about 30 points separating them after they had a lead of about 45 seconds about halfway through this map. 1 minute 43 left. We've got one rotation left after the Yellow hardpoint. These guys from True Ambition really need to pull out all the stops to come back against this Citadel squad.
Yes, certainly, and they haven't let the team of Citadel actually push into this hardpoint. Pastels been uncontested for quite some time, but Carey picks up the kill on Pastels. Now they need to push out this spawn, as we do see Carey pre-aim in the door. Unfortunately, wasn't able to pick up a kill. He does, and at the same time, Dismal's able to pick up one. Unfortunately, Pastels pick up a two-piece, but Carey does pick up that kill, and they got the spawns. They got those favoured spawns they want. They've got their lead out to just under 20 points now. With over a minute 10, they need to keep pushing this hill, as we do see a team kill coming through from Stu. But they just keep contesting, and that's all they need to do with 10 seconds remaining on the next rotation.
Yeah, I love the work there we saw from Citadel. Dismal, but the huge three-piece, one of them being his teammate, Stu. 215 to 189 as we rotate over to the school. You're going to have a few players here from True Ambition already in position. You've got Snopey cleaning out Dismal as he pushes in. But look at this bad decision to push out towards the stairs. It was the player creeping in through your window, taking him down. Carey and Stu from Citadel holding this one down. 40 seconds left on the clock. 227 to 190. It's almost all over as the guys from True Ambition are desperately trying to hang on. It's about to be mathematically impossible for them to come back. But as I say that, they could still do it. But as I say that, now all wrapped up. Benny Sim, it looks like from a very unlikely scenario, Citadel are actually going to be the boys taking out the first game here on the main stage.
Yeah, as you said, it looked like it was all True Ambition to start off this match here, but Citadel were able to climb themselves back into this game, and Pastels had an extremely good game. You see him go 37-32, but unfortunately it wasn't big enough for him to get themselves over the line here, and Citadel are going to walk away with this, I wouldn't say comfortable victories, but they were able to win by 22 points, and Lakey, that three, I think it was six consecutive kills in the garage hardpoint, and they stretched their lead out to over 30 there, so some big plays coming out of Lakey there to get their team over the line, and no one really stood out in regards to the KD, but I tell you, some big individual plays coming from the Citadel team.
Yeah, there was. I mean, Carey was really stepping up there, but I must point out as well that it was Pastels for the True Ambition squad who was really stepping up for me. Trent, we called him out at the beginning, but he actually went worse with that 0.79 KD. It must be said, though, that just as a squad, both teams played really, really well, and it was only in those last couple of rotations where Citadel really charged ahead. It was as soon as they started getting their rotations, Benny. They did the early rotations, which True Ambition were doing from the start. I think they just learnt and adapted as they went, or maybe just shook off the cobwebs from being on main stage. As soon as they had them down pat, they started getting the lead.
Yeah, certainly. As you said, it wasn't in regards to the slaying. They both were getting the kills as much as each other, but those rotations were very important. Obviously, True Ambition had them down early on, and they're able to stretch that lead out to over 30, but Citadel were able to claw themselves back into that. We're going to jump into a Search and Destroy on Recovery next, so it's going to be interesting to see how both teams are going to adapt to a Search and Destroy, especially after that fast-paced hard point we did just see on stream there, and Citadel were able to take the first map out of best of five.
Yeah, that's right. Both teams played their respawn very well. Now jumping into the S&D. I know the guys from True Ambition really love their S&D, but with that said, Citadel really strong squad. You know, they came back there in that hard point, and Citadel have been called as one of the favourites of this competition. Whether that will show in their S&D is the question.
Yeah, certainly. You did mention that, but unfortunately, Citadel, the only two maps they have lost throughout this whole tournament have been Search and Destroy. It's best to have gone to both round 11. So let's see whether they're able to close out this one here, as we see both all players just getting into the lobby on the screen. And the boys of Citadel are getting a little bit excited there. They're just pretty cool, calm, collected, as they always are. But no doubt they will get pumped once they start to get into this game here. We're going to start off with the defensive team, and it's going to be start with Stu. We'll mix it up a little bit. Generally, we go with the attacking. Let's see what they can do off the break.
Yeah, and look, Stu's going to be rocking this this Bao combo. That's interesting. Down the bottom, it's coming up as he's only holding an ASM1. Might be a little bit of a glitch there. Got Pastels here rocking the bomb, going with the OBJ for the squad here of True Ambition. Slowing things down right now, though, as two of his teammates were just taken down. Mets and Snopey take a very early fall, and then so does Tread. Pastels, the only one left alive, up against a full-strength Citadel squad. Now, you mentioned that S&D were the ones that this team dropped, but they've got a really good start here, as they've got a perfect sweep over the guys from TA at the start.
Yeah, definitely. It didn't look like they had any issues with their Search and Destroy in that game there, as we do see Lakey picking up the final kill cam there. Interesting push coming from the team of Citadel. They all sort of pushed that A bomb site, sort of predicting the team of True Ambition to go there. And they caught him off guard. They sort of trapped him in a little bit, as we did see Kerry pick up the first blood and stop that push. We're going to jump on board with Kerry. Obviously, he started off 2-0. Let's see what he's able to do. He's rocking that bell, and he's going to be trying to get those early stuns over there, stop that push coming through the A. He did get that hit marker, so they would have called that out to his teammate, and Lakey was able to pick up Pastels there. So nice first blood going in favour of the team of Citadel yet again.
Yeah, and Lakey rocking this bow again. You know, want to rock, get those ARs out on this long range kind of map. And speaking of which, Mets with the dirty scope there. That was a beautiful two piece. Picked up one with the ASM1, ripped out the thermal scope. Can he get three? No, a little bit too excited. a bit too much adrenaline running through his veins. Shaky shots aren't going to pick it up. You've got Stu in a 2v1 scenario. He does have the bomb in his back pocket. He's going to catch the player in the corner. He's not. Shots in the back. I thought that was almost a potential turn there, Benny. Shaky shots out of the player hiding in the corner. Let's watch it from his POV in the kill cam.
Yeah, certainly. As you said, a couple of shaky shots coming out of Trent there. He was eventually able to pick up the kill, and obviously his teammate Snopey would have been able to exchange that. And that's the first round going on board for the team of True Ambition. And it all thanks to Metz there. As you said, he got that dirty scope to start off with. And I want to jump on board with him, see what he can do with that scope. Generally, he will be rocking it. And we do see have the scope. It looks like I don't know if he had overkill there. It didn't go through the classes. We will run through that again, see whether he's got the ASM1. He does, as we do see Snopey trying to get a scope of his own. But unfortunately, two players for the team of True Ambition drop, and Snopey's left alone over at this A bomb site.
Yeah, Snopey was able to pick up Dismal right off the spawn, but then it was quickly answered back by Trent and Pastels, both taking a fall. So you've got 2v3 right now. Metz has got the backup here for Snopey. Snopey, of course, running that overkill perk, ASM1, along with the thermal moors. We're going to have a look here at where these guys are making a move towards. Carry is just chilling right over here near the dome. You've got Lakey just taking his time as well. Obviously, being on the defense, they have to wait for Snopey and Metz to make a move onto this bomb, which is over on the A street. Now, you've got Metz making a push through the dome. There's a player just laying down out on the corner here. Is he going to grab him? He does. Great awareness there by Metz to pick that one up. Picks up the thermal moors, assuming someone's going to make a move on him. But as I say, that Snopey, his teammate, was taken down on the other end of A street. So Metz is going to be all alone, rips out the thermal moors. Let's have a look at what he's going to do here. Can he get the plant down? He will. The guys from Citadel playing very smart, taking their time, but Lakey pushes out. Perfect timing. He knew that there was going to be a plant going down. Easy to fuse here, so the guys from Citadel will be picking up their second round.
Yeah, certainly. Good plays coming out of the team of Citadel there. You did mention earlier, we saw Lakey and Carey both just playing passively, waiting for the team of True Ambition to sort of make a play there. And they were able to catch him off guard, as Snopey did drop in the same time. So it was a 1v2 situation. Not ideal for Metz. He was able to get the bomb down, but unfortunately wasn't able to pick up the kill, as he did get taken down while planting the bomb. And look at Lakey, 4-1. Started off extremely well, rocking that bell as he generally does. And it looks like a lot of the players for the team of Citadel running that bell at this current stage. We do see both Lakey and Carey. Stu does have that ASM1 in hand, and it looks like they're going to be pushing this quite quickly as Trent does drop in the background.
Yeah, I think it's Shu, the only one with an SMG. The rest of them are running the bow, and it seems to be working for Lakey, going 5-1. As I say, that curse of the caster is going to hit him as he was taken down, but that's a good trade considering Trent and Metz have both been dropped, and they're on the defense, and the bomb has already been planted over at A, so it's going to be on them to make a move. There was a trade that just happened. Pastils killing himself to take down Stu. He thought it was a worthwhile trade. Maybe it was, because now Snopey's going to be the only one left alive. Carrion Dismal still up for the attacking squad.
Yeah, certainly a little bit unfortunate there. He's left Snopey in a 1v2 situation now, and it looks like he's going to be able to pick up that. No, he gets the hit mark on the player. Picks up one, looking for the second player there. Unfortunately, he won't connect the player, and gets the knife. And look at the smile from the boys from Citadel. They knew that was classy, and we're going to be able to watch that in the final kill cam. It looked like a little bit of a slide knife there, so interesting choice coming out of the play from Citadel. I'm not entirely sure whether it was Dismal, and let's have a quick look at that. Says, no thank you, Snopey. I'm just going to give you the knife to the top of the head.
That's a nice kill cam if I've seen one.
Yeah, certainly. Be clicking the Xbox record on that. And they take the lead 3-1. So nice start coming out of the team of Citadel here. We did call them out a little bit earlier. Well, I personally did, saying they're struggling their search and destroy. But they've definitely turned it up here. And it looks like a nice little strong push for the team of Citadel. Oh, unfortunately, a team kill comes down as Kerry is dropped by Lakey. But one player did drop for the meantime. That was Trent for True Ambition, as Pastel does drop in the meantime. Snopey's trying to pick up a couple of kills here with the Mords. Unfortunately, doesn't connect there. Does spot a couple of players. There's three players pushing him, unfortunately. Reloads that Mords, looking for the kills there. They decide to back up. Wise play from the team of Citadel. They don't need to contest here. Snopey did spot that player down bottom here, chasing that kill. And they obviously know where he is, so he's not in a great situation as we speak.
Yeah, that's right. Shaky shots, but he's going to finally pick one up. Is he going to spot the player just around the corner is the question for me. Snopey pushing out. Doesn't spot him. He should go down just like that. Four rounds now to the team of Citadel. Great work by them. Easy cleanup here by Dismal. Now, I just wanted to point out, Snopey, I was on for him for a little while, just waiting for those scopes to connect.
But with his teammate or with the opposition?
Yeah, well, I was hoping for the teammate, but it got, I mean, so sorry, excuse me, I was hoping for the opposition, but all he got was the teammate, so.
Well, we did see a team kill.
At least he connected.
Lakey got a team kill also, so it evens out in the long term.
Well, he can't be showing up, can he?
We will see Snopey trying to, he did spot that play, pushing through that A-bomb site, so he would have called that out to his teammate there, as he is rocking that Moors, spots a play, gets a hit marker yet again, unfortunately. Eventually does pick up the kill there, gets tagged up, but unable to get out, and just like that, we've seen a couple of kills exchanged. We've got Stuart and Kerry up against Metz and Snopey.
Yeah, Snopey getting markers for days with this Moors. He hasn't been having much luck with it. Stu maybe going for the big rotation. He is running that tactician perk, so he's going to be going with the Exo Boost and the Exo Mute. So the Mute's still up his sleeve. He might use that to be a little bit of a sneaky beaver to move towards over towards the B site. It is a 2v2. Metz and Snopey still up for True Ambition. Stu has the backup of Carry. Now, Snopey has just ripped out that scope again for a second. I don't think he's going to be able to do much with it. Stu trying to make the push over towards the A side. If we just have a look here how these guys will react, we may see a bit of a fight go down. Carry's going to be picking up Metz, which means Snopey is the only one left alive. Stu spots him. Snopey does have that scope out. I want to see if he actually get able to connect with anyone besides a teammate with it. He's got 30 seconds before he reacts. All he's going to do is drop.
Yeah, certainly. Smart play coming out of Stu there. He didn't have to contest. Obviously, they were in a 2v1 situation. Just played out the clock and camping that corner, and obviously got Snopey off guard. But interesting to see. Snopey loves to, as we see a few shots coming in there, Snopey loves to actually run that Moors. And we see it in Hardpoint quite often from him. I did yesterday. An interesting choice coming out of him. We're going to start off with him, see if he does have that Moors in the back pocket. He does have the ASM1, and yes, he does. So he's going to probably go for that early snipe here, as we do see he unfortunately didn't spot any players. Gets stuns up quite heavily. And it looks like the team of Citadel like to push his A-bomb site quite hard. Snopey did spot a player, eventually does pick up Lakey there, and they've got the man advantage. So it's good to see they've actually got the first blood here. Obviously, it's 5-1 as Dismal's just running around with that knife, got caught off guard as Snopey's able to pick up Stu. So Kerry's left in a 1v3 situation. He does get spotted up. Does pick up the first kill there on Trent. So he's, sorry, it was 1v4. Left in a 1v3 as we speak now. And the players from True Ambition will be aware where he is. And you can just see the setup as they do get the bomb down. and it's going to be a difficult situation for Kerry to get out of.
Yeah, it really is. I just want to stay on board with him for a little while, just see how he reacts in this 1v3. If he's able to somehow clutch it, it is going to be the ace for him. He gets the shots out. That's two down, so he's halfway to this, but he's also got the time limit, 30 seconds, to also get the defuse as well. He checks the corner, but does he check it well enough? Yes, he does. That's three. Kerry goes for the responsive play as well, the pre-fire on the rear door. Is he going to spot that final player? That's the question. He's looking around desperately. He needs to pick it up as well as get the defuse. Is desperation coming from Kerry right now? He didn't spot the player, just hiding inside there, and unfortunately gets picked off. Credit to him though, Benny, for picking up the big three kills.
Yeah, certainly. As you said, he got a nice little three piece there, trying to go for the fourth. Unfortunately, it wasn't the case.
He had enough time if he spotted him.
Yeah, I think he still had about 12 seconds left on the clock when he did spot him. So a little bit unfortunate for the Kerry there. But some big plays coming out of him. Nearly got the four-piece and get the bomb defuse. And some individual players like that, that's why they're performing so well in this Search and Destroy. As we are going to jump on board with Lakey, see what he can do. Does have that belt, as he generally does. Does get spotted up there, but he's able to run through still as he throws those nades, trying to hit that player up the back there. And he doesn't connect with him. Unusual, as he did throw that nade directly in his... As we do see Snopey just running that Moors yet again, looking for that pick as Pastels and Mets able to pick up a kill. Lakey's able to exchange that on Pastels as Snopey picks up another one, and Stu's left in a 1v3 just like that. The bomb has been planted, so Stu's got the bomb down. Just got to defend this, as I do say, but he's up against three opposition for the team of True Ambition.
Yeah, and he's going to get started by taking down one. He spotted the second player, so how's he going to react to this? Decides to potentially circle back, but he needs to watch out for the defuse. If it happens, not going to matter. Trent picks up the kill over on Stu. Plenty of time left, meaning the guys from True Ambition are going to be picking up another round. They're not out just yet, Benny. It was almost all she wrote for the squad, but they pick up another one. 3-5. It's pretty much elimination time for these guys in this map, though. They need to win the next three in a row. Otherwise, the map is going to go to the guys over at Citadel, which would make two maps in a row.
Yes, certainly. And as I said earlier, Citadel have gone to around 11 in all their Search and Destroys at this current stage. So we still can go to that. Obviously, the team of True Ambition need to get a couple of rounds consecutively if they want to make it go to around 11. As we see Mets pick up the first blood on Dismal there. And that's exactly what they need to start off this comeback yet again. So they've got the man advantage. As we do see Snopey spot that player go down bottom A. He's just waiting for him to poke again. He hasn't seen him push through. As he spots another player on the rock there. And he might get caught off guard here a little bit, unfortunately. He did know that player pushed through, but Kerry misses a couple of shots. And he's going to be able to turn, but unfortunately does get taken down as Stu left in a 1v4 situation consecutively.
If Kerry got that kill, that would have been such a silly play by Snopey by just letting him go down the back A, but the back of A. But, you know, everything turned out better than expected for the squad, right? Stu's still the one up for Citadel right now in a 3v1. It looks like, Benny, you were talking about round 11. We may get there just yet because it's looking very likely that True Ambition are going to be able to pick this one up. But as I say that, Stu's not going down without a fight. Picks up one, two left, but he also needs to get the defuse on this bomb. Will he spot Pastels? That's the question. There's a foot hanging out. Pastels jumps out. Beautiful shot there by Stu. Pastels takes a fall. 1v1. Defuse needs to happen. How is Mets going to respond? Mets hiding here behind the rock, just waiting for the right timing. Stu, is he able to clutch it? That's the question. Is Stu going in? Stu gets it after two big kills, goes for the clutch defuse and gets it, giving Citadel the win. What a play there, Benny.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, he was able to pick up the three kills, actually. Mets decided not to contest him, and Stu just jumped on that bomb straight away with 16 seconds remaining and was able to get the defuse. We see Kerry fall short the round before, but Stu was able to pick up that actually four, I guess you could say a four-man clutch there, as Mitch was unable to get the kill on Stu. He did decide to check the bomb, but it was a little bit too late. And just like that, Citadel are able to take a 2-0 lead in the best of five, and some great individual performances coming out of Stu right there.
I'm in a little bit of shock right now because that was a brilliant play. Mets is probably hanging his head right now, probably a bit disappointed with himself. But, I mean, 9 times out of 10, that play would have worked because the defensive player is always scrambling around trying to find the attacker, you know. But not this time. This time they went straight in for the defuse, and that's why it doesn't always work. Mets had to check it, you know. He had to check after his teammate got taken down. He should have checked the bomb to make sure the defuse wasn't happening, but... You know, look, you can't really blame him. That's a standard play to wait for those last seven or eight seconds to go out and check the bomb. And it was just this time around, Metz was just smart enough to know that and go straight for the fuse.
Well, generally the player like in Stu's situation would generally contest that. He obviously saw where Metz was, but he decided to jump on that bomb straight away. And some great plays coming out of Stu there. And obviously he's one of the most experienced players in our scene. So you expect that sort of play coming out of him. And we're going to go into the third map, which will be an uplink on Biolab. So this is the first time I've actually cast this game throughout, or this map throughout the tournament here. And it's going to be interesting to see which way we do see. We did see the original hard point. Both teams sort of slay themselves. No team outslayed the other. So I expect this to be the same situation. Both teams sort of dropping those big numbers, but it all comes down to teamwork. Obviously, uplink is a team-oriented game. So it's going to come down to who can work best in regards to that.
That's exactly right, Benny. Such a strong performance by both squads. Now heading into the uplink, mixing things up here on the main stage. Now, I do prefer comeback as my uplink map. But, you know, Biolab doesn't go astray either. And we'll just have to see how both of these teams play it out. I want to kick things off here with Metz, only because I want to see if he can shake off that loss in that S&D.
A little bit of redemption, you reckon? Try and bring it out.
I'm hoping so.
He's just rocking that ASM1. He's going to get contested. He pre-fires the door. Unfortunately, a little bit of bad timing there. If he pre-fired a little bit more, he might have collected that play. But looks like a couple down straight away for the team of Tree Ambition as Metz able to pick up one. But Lakey's there to exchange that kill. And Snopey was last left alive. And look at those spawns. Citadel have got some early control here, controlling those spawns, making the team of True Ambition spawn back green. And they should be getting the 2-point slam dunk as Lakey just goes in straight away like that to start off the game.
What a strong start. 2 points within 30 seconds on Biolab is not bad at all. Metz still trying to get that redemption, getting the nade out all towards the satellite drone spawn. But as you can see from your minimap, True Ambition have it locked down, but they need to make a move. Snoby here getting one, pushing out of the back of Blue just there. Now he's going to be just taking his time here. He does have the backup of his team, and look at how stale the guys from Citadel are playing right now. Just all defensive. Metz spotted in there, gets one. There's no other player inside of Purple. But Pastels is going to be able to take him down. He's got the backup of Trent as well. Trent gets the shots out. Finally gets their hot headshot over on carry. Citadel, the drone is going to be in their hands. Stu able to get it through all of the fire. And it's slowly making move over towards the uplink point. But as you can see there from your minimap, there's a couple players just hanging around green. He's going to be under fire as well. But look at the three arrows out there all firing down. Carry's going to be dropped. Stu still able to make a run here. Dashes, dives, weaves, ducks and waves. And finally gets taken down there. I thought he was finally going to be able to make it, but not going to happen. Dismal still keeping it alive. As you can see, the drone is finally thrown out there, which is exactly what the guys from True Ambition needed to do. There was a lot of pressure on them, Benny, very early up.
Yes, certainly, as we do see Pastels jump off with a satellite drone. So he risked his life to or killed himself so that the reset would happen, allow his team to respawn there. But look at Citadel. They're just controlling these spawns at this current stage, and they're making that team of True Ambition spawn back green, which makes it very difficult as Lakey goes for the throw. Able to connect, picks up one, looking for the second kill. Unfortunately, had to reload. He's going to look out and try to contest that play again, but unfortunately gets stomped by Pastels as Dims has that satellite drone yet again. And it just looks like they're just controlling this at this current stage. They're just pushing that team of True Ambition back, but they've been able to get a couple of kills as Diz does pick up one, but unfortunately does drop to Trent there. And good stop coming out of the team of True Ambition as they stopped that push coming through from Citadel, and they've pushed them back into their own spawn.
Yeah, Citadel have just done amazingly well at controlling the spawns and just controlling this map. Lakey's been playing great. He's the new Kobe with that long shot he got in just before. He's getting assists all over the place. He's getting the shots where he needs to. Controlling Purple just to make sure that the guys can't set up a relay to throw the drone through. Because usually what you'll see for the squad of True Ambition, the position they're in, attacking that snow side, you'll get one sitting on top of Purple so they can throw it through and just go straight over. But as I say that, Benny, you're pointing out there's big rotation here from the guys of True Ambition.
Yes, certainly. And smart play coming from Lakey. Obviously did pick up that satellite drone, but he was watching for that overextend. One player did originally overextend and was able to pick up that kill. So he's just controlling those spawns. Unfortunately, the satellite drone is uncontested at this current stage as Metz is able to pick up a kill with that stun in hand. We do see Lakey getting a couple of shots off, looking for that player, gets the fist on him, looking for the second player as he does turn on Snopey, but unfortunately doesn't pick up the kill there. But he's just controlling this, making a bit of a nuisance for the team of True Ambition as they're having to look for him as he gets a little bit of support from his team.
Yeah, I just wanted to point out they're dismal. He was going 17 for 5 before being dropped there. 17 for 6 right now. The closest player to him regarding kills on his squad is 9 on the other side, 11. So dismal, definitely putting the hurt on this True Ambition squad, getting shots out on the player here on Snow. Can the guys here from True Ambition finally make a move? No. The team of Citadel say no. Lakey picks up a kill there. Now it's going to be in the hands of Stu, making a mad dash through Biolab. Look at your minimap in front of you. The teammates are winning their gun battles and just leading the charge for him. Stu still making a run. Player's going to be on top here. Can he get the throw out? He delayed just a little bit. He was punished for it. Benny, he was taken down there. It was looking good there for a minute, though.
Yeah, certainly, but we do see Dims going absolutely 20-7. Now he gets the 2-point play to stretch out the lead 7-0. But what a great rotation from Stu there. He did see the team of True Ambition spawn back green, did the whole rotation through purple and so forth, and they were able to pick it up as carries his control on these spawns at this current stage. And it's going to allow Stu to pass that to his teammate, get the 2-point slam dunk, and he's just going to pick up a kill on Pastels there. There is no stopping this Citadel team at this current stage as Trent tries to with a two-piece, but unfortunately the lead has stretched out to 9-0 with 10 seconds remaining.
Normally we talk about rotations and at the halfway mark how a team that's down will often come back when they flip the spawns, but Benny, Citadel, they aren't relying on which side of the map they are. They are just spanking these guys. They're controlling the map, getting the kills they need, being patient. They're not just rushing and scrambling to get the drone over there, getting the kills they need, and then holding that location and forcing the players to spawn where they want them to.
Yeah, you mentioned getting those important kills. They haven't outslayed the team of True Ambition by much, but they've been able to control those spawns and they get those relay 2-point plays consecutively. So some great teamwork coming out of the team of Citadel, and that's what we highlighted at the start of the game. Whoever's going to use that teamwork to their advantage should be able to capitalize on this, because look at both scoreboards. I mean, other than Dismal, everyone's sort of within that same sort of range. So he's having a great performance yet again from him as he's rocking that bell, as we do see. He's going to see a couple of players, does spot one up top, able to get the assist as Lakey does pick up that kill there. But he's just firing those shots off, just causing a little bit of havoc, tagging up those players as he contests that player in the head glitch there. Interesting is he was one shot, but Pastel eventually drops him.
Yeah, Dismal probably getting a little ahead of himself there. I mean, if he got that one, it was a very aggressive play. I should point out, Lakey going 19 for 9, as well as getting 5 of the 9 points scored so far. That is some ridiculous stats right there. So Lakey definitely putting up the numbers for the Citadel squad. The rest of his team going really well as well. Carry, unfortunately, just being dropped. And Stu, although only going 6 for 14, he got 2 very vital points, and he's been exactly where the team needs him, but it's all about Dismal. Picking up a solid two-piece there. Lakey cleaning it up as well. Expect these guys to make a massive run now towards over at Snow. But it looks to me, Benny, they're just slaying these guys right now.
Yeah, exactly right. What Citadel were able to do there, we did see them in that spawn trap, but they were able to break out of it. They got important kills, and they were able to stop that push coming from the team of True Ambitions. We do see Stu with that satellite drone getting a couple of shots, but he's got a little bit of support from Dismal there, as Dismal's able to pick up one, Carrier's able to pick up another, and that's what they're able to do. They're able to support that satellite drone carrier, and Stu's just playing a little bit of time here, getting a little bit more support as one of his players does unfortunately drop. Lakey gets a couple of shots off, isn't able to capitalize, but Stu goes for that 1-point play, able to connect and stretch that lead out to 10-2 with just over 3 minutes remaining.
Yeah, that was some great plays there from the Citadel squad, and now they're back in control of it again. Lakey tries to throw it over on top of Biolab, wasting some time, which is exactly what you want to do when the rest of your team gets dropped and you're this far ahead. What a smart play then.
Yeah, certainly, and look at Dismal. He's actually OE'd here, so a great play coming out of him. Obviously, he didn't want to get in that spawn trap, but there is one player watching, need to pick up that kill. Big kill coming out of Pastels there, but unfortunately, team does drop at the same time. Looks for a second, able to pick him up, looking for that third player. Unfortunately, does get dropped, and that was Carey, who was able to pick up the kill. He's probably going to go for the hard reset. No, he's going to go, you know what, I want to give you the fist there, but unfortunately, does get taken down by Trent. But Lakey's there to exchange that kill.
Yeah, I mean, look, they're probably just having a little bit of fun now, and why not? You know, you're 10-2 ahead with 2 minutes 30 left, feeling pretty confident, already 2 maps ahead, and you're about to make it 3-0 over this squad here of True Ambition NAGA. Citadel, one of the favourites of the competition, showing why. Very strong right now. 3 points to Stu right now. He's only gone 6 for 18, but he's going to try and extend that to maybe 4. Throws it out there. What a play there to the teammate, and they dunk it through to make it a lead of 12-2.
I'm not entirely sure. I think Lakey was shooting at Stu there, and Stu thought it was probably in opposition, but did pass the ball, satellite drone, as we do see Metz going for a little run of his own here. Decided to go for the throw, but unfortunately did get taken down in the meantime, as Stu's just playing a little bit of Ring and Ring and Rosie with Pastels, but does drop. And it looks like Dismal, the team of Citadel are just looking too strong at this current stage. The team of True Ambition aren't getting any control at all, and they're just not allowing themselves to push through, as we see Dim just throwing that satellite drone, picking an easy kill there. And look at the left-hand board. It is all red at this current stage, and just complete control in favour of the team of Citadel as they're just running through these two-point plays with current ease.
Yeah, I mean, there goes another two. As you say, that 14-2 carries in a great position to get these spawners. Picks up one. There's a couple of players up on top of red there. He cleaned them up pretty easy over on the snow roof. Dismal trying to make another run as well. A minute 12 left. Why not try and get some more points, boys? And that's exactly what he's doing. He's going to get smacked down there inside of the yellow building, though, and then the drone does get thrown out by the True Ambition player, and it shows that, you know, they're at least still trying to make an effort to play this game probably, whereas Citadel, they're only mucking around, but it doesn't matter, they're still getting points on the board. 15-2, 50 seconds left. Would you say, Benny, that this is pretty much all over?
Yeah, certainly. As we see Kerry going on a 5-kill streak, I want to stay on board with him, see what he can finish this game off with. And look at Stu, 10-22, but 5 captures to his, 5 satellite drones to his name. So definitely doing the OBJ, but look at Lakey, 29-17 with 7 captures or 7 satellite points. So he's playing extremely well. He's playing the defense, as we do say this at this current stage, just trying to pick up those kills, a couple assists to his name. But big plays coming out of Lakey there, especially as he's the inclusion to this team. So it doesn't look like there's any issues with that, I guess you could say, chemistry here, as they are working extremely well together. And they've been able to take out this lead 16-2.
These guys know how to throw that drone as well, by the way, Benny. They know how to kick up those 1 points. In fact, I don't think I see the likes of Mind Freak or the Trident players get as many points from those long throws as these guys did, obviously getting their NBA training. So Citadel, great work there. Look at the player left hand.
Poor old Lakey was going for the fist pump there, but Stu said, no, thank you, Lakey. You can just wait for my turn.
Stu's probably a little hurt after the 14-24 KD, but, you know, 5 points to his name. He can't argue with that. So after that one, Benny, 3-0 to the guys of Citadel. They're now in top three territory. Winners bracket final coming up next for those guys. They're in the money. $2,000 in prize money up for grabs. 25,000 MLG pro points. There's a lot at stake here considering there's a few less teams than what we'd normally get. But, I mean, still exciting times ahead, Benny.
Yeah, certainly. As you said, it's the exact same as we would get at any event. And the competition's very high standard still. Obviously, we saw a close counter there. It blew a little bit out in the uplink. But unfortunately, Citadel just proved to be too strong in the end there and secure a 3-0 victory in the winner's bracket. And you said top three now. So they've secured some money, going home with a little bit of cash in their pocket, which is always nice to finish a weekend off, but obviously they're not going to stop there. They're going to continue to push through.
Yeah, that's right. It was a really great match, and guys at home, make sure you let us know what you think of the competition so far. We are up to winner's bracket final with these guys of Citadel. You can follow us and join in on the conversation with that hashtag ACL Melb. Follow us on Twitter at ACL Pro, ACL Pro on Facebook, and ACL Pro Video on YouTube. And of course, Benny, events like this can't happen without the amazing support of our sponsors. Look, I'll start it with your favorite. Caesar be your favorite. DX Racer hooking us up with these amazing seats here. Very comfortable.
One of the most comfortable seats I've actually ever sat on, I'll be honest. Definitely going to hit up the boss at work and see whether we can get a couple of these installed. I don't know how we'll go with that. But
how jealous are you that I get to use these all day in the office, in the ACL
office?
Geez,
I wouldn't go home if I was sitting in one
of
these. But yeah, as you said, definitely without the sponsors, a lot of these events wouldn't be able. And the other big one is Astro. I mean, we've got BenQ and so forth, but Astro, as you see on the screen there, obviously all their new technology is great. Compatibility for every console available. So big thanks to them. And obviously we do have the Astro stand here, which is running the Halo and Smite. So if you're in the Bundoora area in Melbourne, definitely come down, have a couple of games, and be able to enjoy their great facilities they've got here for us.
Yeah, the Astro Feature Station has been running the Smite free-to-play thanks to Hi-Rez Studios and also the Halo tournament as well. So make sure you check that out. They're also here, guys. If you haven't checked them out already, the Astro does have a booth hooking people up with all of their Astro supplies. And also, for the first time in Australia, you can get hands-on with their brand new A40 TR headset, so make sure you go check that one out. Also, on top of Astro, we do have some other sponsors to thank, and I want to give them a shout-out, BenQ, who have been supplying us with their awesome XL and RL monitors, and just monitors all around since 2009. That's 6 years of generosity from these guys, keeping the Australian esports alive, scene alive here at ACL. And of course, HyperX, who have come on for the 2015 season, giving us their RAM and SSDs and helping us out to not only get our PC games and tournaments up and running, but also helping out our stream machines back of stage. Corsair, shout out to them as well. I had a play on one of their mechanical keyboards yesterday, and you know, it felt really good with those cherry keys. I really love them. Corsair hooking us up with their peripherals. And then also, I'd like to just give a shout out as well to Microsoft Australia for hooking us up with their Xboxes. Thanks to Xbox Australia, and also with some copies of the new Windows 10 for our Counter-Strike machines. If you haven't already, get onto that beautiful OS. Love what they're doing. It's free if you had Windows 8.1 or I believe 7. So anyway, that's going to be us for a moment. We're going to be cutting to a quick commercial break, and we'll be back with our next series. Don't you go anywhere.